Next, the war in Afghanistan, as seen by a country with its own troubled connection to war. Margaret Warner, who has reported all week from Europe, sent this from Berlin.
It's the Christmas season in Germany, and Berliners are deep into the festivities at one of this city's traditional Christmas markets. Among the crowd, three soldiers home between tours of duty with their medical regiment company in Afghanistan. The two young sergeants, both paramedics, and their captain feel the work their company does helping Afghans is vital and appreciated.
So you liked going on international missions?
Yes.
And why?
To help to the people in the other nation, to help the children.
German citizens, yeah, they support us.
Germany has 4,300 troops in Afghanistan, the third largest contingent after the U.S. and Britain. Germany insisted they be sent as peacekeepers to the relatively tranquil north. After 8 years, they've lost 34 soldiers. The British, who are seeing fierce combat, have only twice as many troops, yet seven times more casualties than the Germans. But the German public's feelings about the mission are as chilly as December in Berlin. A recent poll showed nearly 70% want their forces to leave.
I think it's a senseless war, and it's not... I think it's good to feel responsible, even for other countries and other cultures, but I think it's not right to do it this way, like to send troops.
Soldaten töten, dann ist es Mord.
When soldiers kill, it's murder. There is no good reason to fight wars for Germans or anybody else. Of course, for Germans to do it, it's even worse.
Constanze Steitzenmuller, a senior fellow with the German Marshall Fund, said the reason for these feelings is clear.
Well, I think it's the legacy of a profoundly pacifist culture created by the guilt, the knowledge of our guilt in perpetrating two world wars and a Holocaust. It's that simple.
That national guilt is on display in this sea of gray slabs, marking one of those dark chapters.
The key to understanding why Germany is so wary about any offensive military mission that could kill civilians lies here. The Germans were so intent that succeeding generations never forget the horrors of aggression that they built this memorial to the victims of the Holocaust right in the heart of Berlin.
It's a site full of historical interest. There you find the
Berlin tour guide Martin Ostrowski took us to some stops on his historical Third Reich tour.
We have here the former headquarters of the SS, which administrated the concentration camps. There you can see the Ministry of Aviation, once built for Hermann Göring. He was one of the top Nazis.
What do you think Germans take from that history that affects their thinking about the Afghanistan conflict and Germany's role in it?
Our history just tells us that a war was leading us into a catastrophe, into such a catastrophe that we don't like to be connected again so much to a war.
We went to a cafe next to Checkpoint Charlie, a remnant of the 50-year division of Berlin. He recalled his own family's bitter experience with war.
I think there is no good reason for any war. The best reason is how to avoid a war, and instead of making conflicts, is how to find a solution of cooperating.
But whether Germans like it or not, their mission in Afghanistan is moving in the other direction. In the last 6 months, the Taliban have stepped up attacks in the north, drawing German soldiers into combat. Retired General Harold Kuyat, former chief of staff of the German armed forces, says German troops were caught off guard, outmanned and outgunned.
The Germans were more and more in a defensive role. And my personal assessment is that they are no longer in the situation to provide a secure environment in the north, because they have to defend themselves.
That was brought home by a bloody September 4th incident near Kunduz, when a German colonel called in a NATO airstrike on two Taliban-hijacked fuel tankers, killing more than 140, including dozens of civilians. Since then, three top German government officials have resigned amid charges they withheld information about the civilian deaths.
The idea that civilians might be killed recklessly in an act perpetrated by a German officer is deeply disturbing to the German public. By calling in an airstrike, the Germans found that they had done something that they had been lecturing the Americans for doing all the time.
The Kunduz incident also made it crystal clear to the German public that their soldiers are indeed engaged in combat. That's been unsettling to a nation that saw its disgraced Nazi-era army dismantled after World War II, and street protests against remilitarization at the creation of the new army and a draft in the 1950s. And for 35 years, that Cold War-era force was restricted by law to defending the home front against a possible Soviet invasion.
The German armed forces, the Bundeswehr, have been in combat in the north of Afghanistan since the early spring. That is something that took the Germans a long time to take on board. But now that they have, they are very uncomfortable with it. They're very unhappy with it.
Yet that unhappiness didn't bring people out to the streets this time. And some Germans agree with what President Obama said yesterday in his Nobel Peace Prize acceptance speech, that the horrors perpetrated by Nazi Germany teach there's sometimes a duty to intervene. Ad copywriter Matthias Wernicke says Germany's past shouldn't restrict its military future within NATO.
I think it's the past. That's 60 years ago, and yeah, it was terrible and everything, but nowadays are other days. Today, Germany is not the Third Reich anymore. It's a modern democracy, and so it has a responsibility to the world.
Still, it's politically risky for the German government to step up to Mr. Obama's call for NATO countries to send more troops to Afghanistan. German Chancellor Angela Merkel has said Germany will decide after an international Afghanistan conference in late January. Peter Altmaier, the parliamentary whip for Merkel's party, was noncommittal on what Germany will do.
I cannot tell you today what concrete measures will be adopted, but we are aware of the challenge and we will certainly respond to it. This government, led by Angela Merkel, has been a reliable partner over the last 4 years. And I'm 100% convinced we will remain and continue to be a reliable partner for the future.
General Kuyat argues Germany needs to add forces immediately to protect its mission on the ground.
We need to act now. We should have acted already yesterday, but we need to act now. We don't have time.
So as Germans revel in the magic of the season, they know they have a big decision ahead.